That's they could have awesome. They could have easily sort of turned around and said, "Mate, you know, get your act together, get your life together, and
you're dreaming.
Yeah, you're dreaming. You're dreaming." But yeah, no, everyone's just been so good. My close friends and family to doing that. The surf club, Crumbin Surf Club, Brett Robinson.
Crumbin Vikings.
So we got the surf club, and then the specialised group of the beach athletes from there, which is Viking Athletics. Brett Robinson, the head coach. And all the athletes there that have been with me on the journey. You don't get there without, you know, guys pushing every day on the training track. And, you know, we've certainly got an unbelievable group there that sort of is super professional in what they do every day. My team at the moment, in terms of I've got Lou on board and helping with recovery.
Lou Ferguson, yep.
Yeah, just here in Burleigh Heads, and she does an amazing job with everyone from elite athletes right down to, you know, just the weekend warriors that are, you know, trying to get out there on a surfboard or whatever they do, on a mountain bike, or just, you know, playing, you know, over 30s cricket or something like that, and wanting to feel a little bit better during the week. I've got my physio, Surf Life Physio. I've got an osteo that I use, Ashmore Osteopathic Group, David up there. Momentum Sports Performance Center is who I use for all our gym stuff. So Wade and the boys there, they're in this complex as well. They're in the old Billabong factory, and they've just sort of come down the back of this section now as well. So Wade and all the guys from Momentum, they've done all our gym programs leading in, and he'll do my gym program leading into the games as well. So he's just does a phenomenal job out there as well. And there's probably someone I'm going to forget, physios, gyms, but that's
girlfriends.
Yeah, no.
Mum and dad.
No, bachelor at the moment, yeah.
Varsity College first.
Varsity College, yeah, yeah, absolutely. Yeah, the school community out there, they've been awesome as well.
Can I say one last one?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Rika, any last ones for you?
No.
What are you doing Tuesday night?
Hey?
What? I was just trying to hook you up again. Sorry.
He tries to hook me up with anyone.
Well,
that
it is Tuesday.
What's
Brandon doing tonight? You know, is that did you tee up that
of course.
Last week?
I said. To her, week? I said. Anyway,
it's 24. My daughter's 26. Yeah. Okay.
Hey, what do you do? Okay. Race day. Is there any, what should we all eat to feel better if we want to do something good? Because I sometimes eat the worst thing, just like, oh man, I'm burping. What do you do?
Race day, you got to keep it. You got to keep the big things to keep the sauce, dairy, all that sort of stuff out. So for me, morning, brekkie, got to be eggs on toast. Got to be eggs on toast.
But not white bread?
No.
Tip top.
Oh, get yourself some good sourdough or some rye or something like that. You know, take yourself to a good cafe.
I'm just trying to look for more sponsors for you. Tip top's the one.
There's got to be some good cafes around Gold Coast.
Okay. Ooh. So say it again, you got eggs on toast.
Yeah, eggs on toast, bit of spinach, and bit of tomato, that sort of thing.
Do you have salt and pepper?
Yeah, a little bit of salt and pepper. Salt's good for your sort of muscles and it making is. Sure they're not cramping up. So we have to have a bit of salt on race days and that as well. Then just sort of that midday meal, just usually some almonds or something like that, maybe a muesli bar. And then lunchtime, stock standard chicken wrap. That's my go-to. Chicken wrap, bit of spinach, bit of, you know, avocado, whatever you want to throw in there. Just on a whole grain wrap, and then from there it gets depending on the time we race. If we race in the afternoon, that's probably the last meal. If we don't race in the afternoon, then we might get through to one more meal, and if that's the case, it tends to be something pretty light, like peanut butter on a couple of crackers or something like that, just something to get you through.
Okay.
So yeah,
nothing with sugar or something like. Oh, anything? Do you ever have the need? Like, I feel like I need some energy.
Just in the pre-game, yeah. Like while I'm at warm up, yeah. Sometimes I'll go a few sips of like a Red Bull or something like that. Definitely coffee in the morning as well. You've got to have a coffee in the morning to get you going. Right. And, sometimes just like a handful of the old Allen's Red Frogs or something like that. Right. And, you know, get a bit of sugar
have,
going.
Do you have real coffee or instant coffee?
Oh, definitely real coffee.
Yeah.
Well, see, we live such boring lives, athletes. We've got to make, like, coffee's coffee's our beer, you know.
Yeah, right, of course.
You've got to make it a social event every day.
Right, where's your coffee shop then?
Well, my little local, I will give them a shout out. My little local one is Lakeview, down there on Burley Street, just on the way in, sort of connecting Christine Avenue and James Street there. So they do a great job, and Dylan behind the desk there. He's a serious coffee man, mate. You don't want to.
Yeah.
You know, I've seen
but
some.
But coffee's, you know, like a good coffee.
Mm.
It is. It's like having a good. You know, like it's like having a good wine or good tequila.
Oh, yeah.
It is because you can have, you know.
You crave it.
Mm.
Some cafes, they might have the baristas and the, you know, the flash machines and everything. But if the coffee isn't good coffee, then it's just yuck.
Yeah.
You know, I'd rather make my own with my pod.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
I love it. You can have all the gear, but doesn't mean anything.
Yeah. All right.
Is that it?
Is it?
Is it?
Yeah.
I reckon.
Yeah,
now, I just want to spend this next 10 minutes. Everyone in the room, MattG Photography, thank you. Aaron Brunner, thank you. Didn't do much, but thank you. Oh, okay.
He's
Rika Waters.
He's sacrificing his time.
Rika Waters, your champion, as always. Thank now, you. Together as a group, right, let's just close our eyes for 10 seconds and wish this man every bit of power there ever is, right, because we're all cheering for you, champion, right? This stuff doesn't come along, we didn't even know you won the thing in Melbourne.
Oh, that's all.
You know, can I just answer one quick question before?
Yep.
When you did win the... what was the other thing down in Melbourne?
The Stawell one. The Stawell gift.
Stawell gift.
Yeah.
Did you have any press? Did the Borden or CFM or anyone like
that? Yeah, they got behind it. And,
did they? Great.
Yeah, it was really good. Like, there was a fair bit of publicity. I actually, one of the lead-ons, I didn't talk about it, but one of the lead-ons from that was I went down and did the, do you remember Hamish and Andy did the race that slows down the nation? It was a horse suit. They got 50 guys in horse suits. And it was the day before Melbourne Cup. They took, you know, typical Hamish and Eddie's taking the mickey out of, something. So they got 50 guys into horse suits to run around a track down in this real remote place in Victoria.
Right.
So I went down there. I actually took that out as well. And I got to meet the boys down there.
So they had
there.
Real runners in there.
Yeah, real runners. Yeah, real runners in horse suits. So,
were you one of them?
Yeah, I was one of them.
let's look that up.
That's awesome.
Yeah, the race that slows down the nation. So I won that. I won that just off the back of the stall stuff as well. Yeah, it was very cool. So
come on, come on, champ. Ready?
Come on, Aussie. Come on.
Hold your breath.
And then the light goes green, and everyone goes
bang. Yeah, come on, man. Yeah, put it there again.
Thank you very much, mate.
This podcast is brought to you by Koala Kamba, the chill out drink. Sit back, relax,
and hold your breath until you see it all. Different colours of green.
Go!
Bang.
All right, thank you, mate.
Thanks, boss.
Oh, that was so much fun. Thank you.
Thanks for doing it. Try to be best, cause you're only a man, and a man's got to learn to take it. Try to believe,